The distribution, storage, and delivery of medical gases is an important but often forgotten topic in the field of respiratory care. In general, oxygen delivery systems store medical gases at extremely high pressures. So before a gas can be administered to a patient, the pressure must be reduced to a safe and workable level. We also need a way to adjust and control the rate of gas flow that is administered, which can be done by using a flow meter. In general, there are three types of flow meters, including Thorpe tubes, flow resistors, and Bourdon gauges. In this video, we're specifically focusing on the Bourdon gauge, and we'll cover the medical definition and provide you with a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. A Bourdon gauge is a flow meter device that uses a fixed orifice and operates under variable pressures that can be adjusted with a pressure-reducing valve. The gauge itself actually measures pressure changes, however, it displays the corresponding flow, which is useful for us as respiratory therapists because it allows us to accurately deliver a specific amount of a medical gas to a patient. When delivering a medical gas, we would want to use a Bourdon gauge whenever a flow meter cannot be maintained in an upright position. A common example of this would be when a patient is being transported with a portable oxygen tank. And the most commonly used tank in this case would be a size E cylinder. So while using one of these tanks during transport, sometimes it can be difficult to keep the tank in an upright position. A Bourdon gauge has a continuous range of flows, which makes it the metering device of choice in these patient transport situations. Thankfully, grab-and-go systems were invented and they made life so much easier because they essentially combined the oxygen cylinder with a pressure regulator and an adaptable flow resistor so that we can set the oxygen flow. These systems basically eliminated the need for individual tanks, regulators, and the tools needed to mount them properly. Again, for this video, we just wanted to provide you with a brief overview of this topic. We'll be breaking it down into much more detail in a separate video. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for educational and informational purposes only. And if you want to dive deeper and learn more about this topic, you can go to respiratorytherapyzone.com, where we have a ton of free study guides, practice questions, and other helpful resources. I'll drop links to everything you need right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.